A close-up of Newton's cradle. When one sphere at the end is lifted and released, it strikes the stationary spheres, transmitting a force through the stationary spheres that pushes the last sphere upward. The last sphere swings back and strikes the nearly stationary spheres, repeating the effect in the opposite direction. Newton's Law, inclusive sixth grade science with Jamie Keeley, general education science teacher.
For me, the most essential thing was thinking about the motion essential element, and that is for him to understand mass and height and how that affects motion.
A middle school science classroom, a student is working with a Newton's cradle.
So if I can isolate Newton's third law and use a hands-on manipulative such as a Newton's cradle, we can generate models where he can see if I drop one sphere at a certain height, the only one sphere will move on the other side as an opposite reaction. But if I drop two spheres, then we can see two. So as a direct result from his motion, he can see the result. So I can isolate at least one of those points, which is how height is involved with motion.
Ms. Keeley sitting next to AJ and his lab partner at a table. AJ is using a Newton's cradle as Ms. Keeley provides an explanation.
You don't want to throw it. You want to just let your fingers go. There you go.
Look how cool that is. See? So look.
AJ, a sixth grade student.
What's happening, science experiment girl?
So you're doing an experiment with a girl?
Yes.
And she's helping you?
Yeah, class.
Nice.
Ms. Keeley, standing at the front of the science classroom, speaking to her group of students.
Are you only able to bring one of the spheres up at a time? No. What could you do?
You could do four.
You could do four? Wouldn't be that exciting because it would just kind of be like this.
Ms. Keeley passing out Newton's cradles to the students in the class. She and Melissa DeTota, an EC support staff member, are demonstrating how to use the cradles with the students.
It is even the simplest little tangle can cause a big, big problem. So guys, do not touch these yet.
These are Newton's
cradles. Who is
with
me?
Ms. DeTota is kneeling next to AJ. She and Ms. Keeley are demonstrating Newton's cradle.
AJ, you want to make sure that these strings aren't like this. See how it's not tight? So when you pull it back in the middle, like this, keep it straight, and then just let it go. Let it go.
AJ pulls one of the metal spheres out and releases it. When the released sphere hits the group of stationary spheres, one sphere on the opposite end goes up.
How many came up over here? You see it? How many is coming up?
Two? One?
One! Good.
Good job.
Ms. Keeley walking around the room. She is stopping at different groups to discuss what they are seeing with their Newton cradle demonstrations.
If there's more energy in the system, the reactions are going to have more energy because they're going to be equal and opposite. Exactly.
Ms. DeTota working with AJ and his lab partner. AJ pulls one of the metal spheres out and releases it. When the released sphere hits the group of stationary spheres, one sphere on the opposite end goes up.
You gotta make sure that's tight. There you go. Let it go. How many over here bounce up?
One.
One. So you used one ball, and one ball bounced up over here.
You can
count these.
AJ counts the number of spheres in the Newton's cradle. His lab partner assists.
How many is that?
Four.
Uh-huh. Yep. So find your number four.
AJ presses four into a program on his tablet.
There you go.
Good job. You crash your bike.
Ms. DeTota is kneeling next to AJ. He is working on his laptop. He motions for her to step away, indicating he wants to do the work himself.
You don't want me to read it to you? How are you going? You go ahead. Let me see. Oh, man. Okay.
AJ smiles and does a small fist pump. His lab partner smiles in support.
Got it right?
Yeah.